celebrating 15 years of Young Turks.
To this very special edition of Young Turks. As you just saw, Cape Town is indeed emerging as a startup hub for the African continent. And today we will be bringing you all the action from the 6th annual Dell Women's Entrepreneur Network Summit that was held in the city. The theme for the summit this year was Innovate for a Future Ready World, and 200 entrepreneurs from 6 continents came together to explore how they can create global businesses.
Welcome again to Dell's Women Entrepreneur Network in our beautiful, beautiful city of Cape Town.
The song that they sang as they were welcoming you means, wake up women, there is a new opportunity for you.
It's really intriguing and interesting in South Africa, there are actually as many women entrepreneurs as men.
There's no balance. All the balls are up in the air, as long as we don't drop it.
Be confident, because we still live in a world where people say to women what they can't do rather than what they can.
I want to say thank you, because that has made me to understand so much more about the work that we do as entrepreneurs.
This is going to change my future. The skills I've learned, I am going to open my own business and it's going to be successful.
Well, let's get straight to our first feature, the very young and very charismatic Michaela Ulmer. She's all of 11. Yes, you heard that right. And the founder and CEO of Me and the Bees Lemonade, for which she clinched $60,000 on America's most watched startup show Shark Tank. Well, she impressed the sharks and sure did impress us too. Here's Michaela's startup story.
My name is Michaela Ulmer. I'm 11 years old, and I'm the founder and CEO of Me and the Bees Lemonade. So I started my company when I was 4.5 years old, and I signed up in 2 kids' business contests, and I had no idea what product to create. So when I was trying to come up with one, I got stung by 2 bees in 1 week. My great-granny also sent me a 1940s cookbook with her favorite recipe of flaxseed lemonade in it. I was so afraid of the bees that my parents encouraged me to do some research on them. And I did that research and I found out how incredibly important pollinators that they are and that they're dying. So I decided to create a product that helps save the bees and that uses my great-granny Helen's recipe as well. The first capital and the first amount of funding that I got was a $50 money order from my Uncle Alfonso. And my dad wanted to teach me all about business and finance, so I decided to sign up in the business fair. He taught me how to go through a budget, and I went through my first budget, and I found out that I needed $75, and that was for ingredients, to get wood for a lemonade stand, to get a juicer, and then I got a $25 loan from my parents, and that was $75, which is just enough to start my business. I got a profit, and I was like, hey, I could be a businesswoman someday. Since Shark Tank aired, we have grown about 400%. Mr. Damon on the show, we offered 25% of our company, and he would give us $60,000, and that was our deal on the show. But later on, we thought that why don't we keep Mr. Damon as a mentor? And he's like, yes, I would love to mentor you guys. And he's helped us get a pilot in Starbucks that's in Austin for now. And hopefully if it does good, we'll be national. Most of my business events are after school, on breaks, weekends, and in the summer. And then usually it's like once every 2 or 3 weeks that I may travel and miss the school. But considering how big my business is growing, that's pretty good. So that is a little bit about how I manage my time.
Well, Michaela, you're managing just fine, and all the very best to you. Our next feature on the show is Jenny Dawson's Rubies in the Rubble. This London-based startup is on a mission to reduce food waste and present a model for food sustainability by converting discarded produce into a line of chutneys, relishes, and sauces. Here's the Rubies in the Rubble story.
Food waste is a big problem that is little known. Piles of edible fruits and vegetables are thrown away every day due to less than perfect color, texture or shape. For Jenny Dawson, who grew up on a farm in Scotland, these statistics seemed criminal. Jenny, who had been working in London as a hedge fund manager, was itching to do something more. Something more meaningful, and she started the project Rubies in the Rubble in 2010. The beginning of the project was like a treasure hunt. Once the right hint was found, the rest of the process fell into place.
I'd read about these fruit and veg markets that started at midnight and closed at around 6 a.m. in London. So I set my alarm at 4 a.m. and cycled down to these fruit and veg markets. And it was there that the whole thing started, of seeing piles of fruit and veg that were being discarded. And I couldn't see anything wrong with them. They looked perfect in my eyes, really. And I could definitely make them into one of my mother's jams or chutneys that she used to make in her vegetable garden.
Starting with a team of just 6 women, Jenny focused on having her product be eco-friendly and sustainable in all its aspects, from the packaging and labeling to the actual production process.
I collected jam jars and glass jars from the back of hotels and restaurants around London. Our labels were all cut-off materials from material factories. Then we were working with women that were homeless and seen by society as unemployable. The fruit and veg was pretty much free because it's coming straight from the market, and the men were saying, you know, this is not going to be sold. I get charged to throw it away, so you can take it off my hands. So when we started, our startup costs were very low.
The seed funding for the company came from Jenny's own savings and a £3,000 grant from Unlimited, a London-based network that supports social businesses. Rubies in the Rubble broke even in 2015 and has been growing at 120% year on year. The growth has helped the company branch out and establish important partnerships.
And we work with Marriott Hotel Group, Virgin Trains, hopefully about to be at Virgin Airlines as well, and quite a few cafes, burger chains. And in terms of retailers, we definitely are a premium brand. We're in Fortnum & Mason's and Harvey Nichols in a lot of the big food halls in London.
Currently, the company produces over 1,000 jars of products every week, which can be bought from many UK grocery stores for £5 or less. Having now raised £100,000 in funding from Mustard Seed, a platform connecting social entrepreneurs with investors, Rubies in the Rubble is looking to launch a line of hot sauces and snacks, as well as partner with more stores and companies, helping to propel the brand forward.
More power to you, Jenny, and your mission of changing the world with a clutch full of rubies at a time. Time for a break on Young Turks. When we return, 2 entrepreneurs from the African continent share with us their startup stories. Stay tuned.
Celebrating 15 years of Young Turks.